Hi friends, this is the T section. In this we need to calculate the shear stress distribution over the entire T section. And we can learn how to draw the shear stress distribution diagram for the required T section. In the T section, we seen one flange and one web. So, the basic formula for the shear stress is tau. It is denoted by tau equals to Fa y bar by Ib. In here, F is denoted as shear force. A is cross sectional area. Y bar. Distance from the neutral axis to the required section. I denoted as moment of inertia. Here B, width of the section. So the shear force value is already seen in the question. So it is assumed as shear force is equals to 200 kilonewton. So 200 into 10 to the power of 3 newtons. In that, first we need to calculate the y bar distance and I, moment of inertia value. So for y bar we have the formula that a1 y1 plus a2 y2 by a1 plus a2. So here I am taking the section 1 as a flange, I am taking the section 2 as a web. So area means 100 into 20, this is the area. Y1 means I am assuming the datum from the bottom of this T section. So y1 means from the bottom to the centroid of the section 1, it is called as y1, and from the bottom to the centroid of the section 2 is called as a y2. So here y1 is equals to, how we calculate, from bottom to the web top point this is a 100, and from centroid means 20 by 2. So y1 is equals to 100 plus 20 by 2, it is 110 mm. So y2 means 100 divided by 2. Y2 means 100 divided by 2, 50 mm. So y bar is equals to a1, it's 2000, 100 into 20 into 110, plus again 100 into 20, it is 2000 into 50 by 2000 plus 2000, therefore y bar is equals to, so the y bar is 80 mm, which is from the bottom, so I am assuming a neutral axis line from here. So this is a y bar bottom as we calculated at 80 mm. So y bar top is how much? Overall depth minus y bar from the bottom. So 120 minus 80, it is a 40 mm value. From here y bar value is completed. So now we have to calculate the moment of inertia for the entire T section. So how many sections are present in the T section? That is 2. So overall moment of inertia is equals to moment of inertia for section 1 and moment of inertia for section 2. So moment of inertia formula is BDQ by 12 plus AH square. Here for section 1, A1H1 square. Similarly, BDQ by 12 plus A2H2 square. Here H1 represents Y bar minus Y1. H2 represents Y bar minus Y2. So BDQ by 12. Means for the section 1, what is the B value? 100 is a B, and depth is how much? 20. So 100 into 20 cube by 12 plus area is 2000 H1. H1 means y bar minus y1. Y bar is how much? 80 mm. Do remember that y bar means always we take the y bar from the bottom section only, not for the top, because we can take the y1 and y2 values with respect to bottom only. So we can take the y bar for the bottom section, bottom from bottom only. So y bar means 80, y1 how much? 110. So 80 minus 110 whole square. This is for moment of inertia of section 1. Similarly, VDQ. For the section 2, what is the B value? 20 and D is 100. So 20 into 100 cube by 12 plus area is again 2000. H2 means y bar minus y2. It is 80 minus 50 whole square. It will give the entire I value. So the value is 5.33 into 10 to the power of 6 mm power 4. This is the I value for the entire T section. So now we calculate the shear stress distribution. Shear stress distribution. Listen carefully. For the T section, there is a three shear stress values. One is with respect to flange and web, tau 1. Next, tau 2, with respect to web and flange point, flange joints. And final shear stress, that is shear stress at the neutral axis. So how many shear stress we need to calculate? Three shear stresses. Shear stress at the top and bottom fibers will be zero. So shear stress at the flange and web we need to calculate, and shear stress at the web and flange, and finally shear stress at the neutral axis. So first one, shear stress at the flange and web. So tau 1 is equals to, general formula is what is Fy bar by Ib. So here F, what we take? 200 into 10 to the power of 3. 200 into 10 to the power of 3 into area of the section at the flange and web is how much? 100 into 20. So 2000 into, here y bar means not this 80 mm, y bar means from the neutral axis point to centroid of the required section. So from the neutral axis to top, how, what is the distance? 40 mm. So this entire is 40 mm from here to here. We want from here to here only. So 40 minus 20 divided by 2. So how we can take y bar value? 40 minus 20 divided by 2. So it is comes as 30. Fa y bar by I means overall inertia. 5.33 into 10 to the power of 6. So notice this one. B means the width of the section. What we can calculate now? The shear stress distribution with respect to flange and web. So we need to find the take the flange width only 100. If we calculate the shear stress with respect to web and flange, we take the width as web width only. So now we can calculate the flange with respect to flange. So B is 100. It will give the tau 1 value. So the value is 22.51 newton per. Now shear stress, second one. Shear stress at the web and flange. So now we calculate with respect to web. So tau 2 is again same format, Fay bar by Ib only. So here F is 200 into 10 to the power of 3. A means similarly same for the section 1, 2000. Y bar also same at the web and flange, or flange and web, both are lies this point only. So y bar is also same, 40 minus 20 divided by 2 by I value for entire section same, 5.33 into 10 to the power of 6. Here B, what we calculating now? With respect to web and flange, so we need to take the width as a web width only, 20. This was the only change for the first shear stress and second shear stress. Here we put it as 20. So tau 2 is equals to, so the value is 112.57 newton per mm square. So finally, last we can calculate shear stress at the neutral axis point. shear stress at the neutral axis. So I am draw the section from the neutral axis here. This is the neutral axis. From neutral axis to top fiber, what is the distance? 40 mm. What is the flange width? 100. Depth 20. Thickness of the web is 20. So this is 40, means this is how much? 40 minus 20. So 20 this. So we need to calculate the y bar for this entire small t portion. So here tau is same, FA y bar by IB. But for this we can calculate the combination of A y bar directly. But in that, what we can take, A is taken separately and y bar is separately from the neutral axis to centroid. But for the neutral axis we can take the area and y bar for the both the sections. So A y bar means A1 y bar 1 plus A2 y bar 2. So here A1 how much? 2000 into y bar means 40 minus 20 divided by 2. 40 minus 20 divided by 2 plus A2. A2 how we calculate? Width is 20, depth is how much? 20. So 20 into 20. Y bar 2 means 40 minus 20 divided by 2 means 20 by 2. 20 by 2. So it will give the entire A y bar value. So the value is 64,000 mm³. So for the T section we can take the width is how much? At the neutral axis what is the width is present? Only the web width. So B is equals to 20 mm. Therefore shear stress at the neutral axis is F value 200 into 10 to the power of 3 into A y bar combination 64,000 directly. I value 5.33 into 10 to the power of 6. B value 20. It will give the shear stress at the neutral axis. So the value is 120.07 Newton per mm square tau. So we had done all the shear stress values. So finally we can draw the shear stress distribution for the required T section. So this was a diagram of our T section. So baseline for the shear stress distribution. Here top fiber and bottom fiber, the shear stress values are 0. With respect to flange and web, shear stress is how much? 22.51. So here 22.51. It is taken as a parabolic curve. And from here, this point, what we had calculated? With respect to web and flange, with respect to web and flange, what is the shear stress value? 112.57. So it is extended up to 112.57. So shear stress at the neutral axis is how much? 120.07. So it lies here. It is also parabolic. From here to here, there is no shear stress. So it is gradually decreases and joins to the zero. First, this was the shear stress.